Oh, she's gone now. Oh, hi. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Is this on? Is this live? Are we live? This is always a problem with this stupid thing. Now it's live. I still don't know if it's live. This is damn irritating, man. Okay, apparently we are live because ads have started. Hi, I think everybody is happy in life. I hope everybody's doing good. Late OP again, once again, it's true. Ajay Satpute says, Saurabh, bus, bus, bus. I agree with you. I have sinned. A lot of our panelists are having massive internet issues, which is the reason for all these delays. Ajay Satpute says Sumukhi is awesome. Nails with Prachi says Among Us खेल के हो जाएगा फिर अगेन वेरी लेट ओपी स्पैम करेंगे करो बिंदास. हेलो वर्ल्ड सेज सौरभ इरेग्युलर ओपी दिस इज मेक्स मोर सेंस इरेग्युलर इनएफिशिएंट इनएफिशिएंट ओपी इज अ की थिंग हियर. Let him start it first, then I'll like the stream. हाँ हाँ आराम से कुछ अभी शुरू तो होने दो. So late, oh pant, that's cool. Not live, we are live. You lie, liar, Tanuj is trying to lie to me. Okay, welcome to the show. Sorry for the delay as always. Just a couple of things to announce before we begin. On today's Saturday, on Monday, which is 26th of this month, we have Hardik Pandya coming in, which is going to be super exciting. One of my favorite cricketers and one of the most premier all-rounders in the world. He's going to be coming in. We also have Manan Desai along with him because they know each other from a way back. I don't want to say the word friends and all because I don't know if they're friends. We'll find out if they're friends. So Hardik Pandya is going to be there 6 p.m. on Monday. Then we're taking a break for a couple of days just to ensure that that video gets insane traction and gets 7.8 million views. And then Saturday, next Saturday, we have Ranveer Alabadia and a bunch of other people. I'll announce that. Also tonight, 6 p.m., which is today's 6 p.m., I have a stand-up show. I've forgotten which show it is, but there is a show. There are two separate shows happening tonight and one tomorrow. Tonight is Traveling Pants 2020 at 6 p.m. on Zoom, so you can watch it anywhere. And then tomorrow, which is Sunday, 6 p.m. is Rant of the Pant Lockdown Edition. Both shows are completely different, so you can check that out on saurabhpanth.com for tickets, guys. All right. Shriya Malhotra Singh, Kaniz is too good. Rahil Lakhani says it will be so funny. Lots of people. Cool. Let me bring on my guest for the day. You recognize him from shows such as The Office Indian Edition. Please give it up for Naveen Richard. Naveen Richard is here. Naveen.
The Office Indian Edition.
It's called Better Life for Lashan.
There's a real Office Indian Edition. Please do not associate me with that treachery.
Oh. Slaps in the face of other shows have already started to happen here. Naveen, what are the other shows you like to diss? I don't know why I'm speaking in this voice, by the way. I don't know
why. No, it's a, no, it was a good, no, my good friend Debbie directed it. So, you know, I think she did a pretty good job of helping it out. But yeah.
Debbie directed the Office Indian Edition also, is it?
Yeah. She directed Better Life Foundation and then she did that Office Indian Edition as well. You know, to be honest, I haven't seen much of it, so I can't speak. I'm still reeling from the from being mad at them taking down my show. So that's the venom is spewing by mistake. It's splattering on the side.
Did you say you're speaking about marriage?
What?
What did you say? Oh, because your show is not on some
place. Yeah, because they took down my show and then they put the Indian edition of The Office. Oh. I'm like, what about my show? Put that back on and I will support your other endeavors, Hotstar Disney.
Yeah, Hotstar Disney rocks, guys. I love Hotstar Disney. Great shows. Samukhi's in the waiting room. I know. I'm just trying to get a proper introduction going, Niharika. There has to be a flow to conversations. So, I know I'm aware she's there. I can't just randomly say, Naveen, shut the fuck up. You're Samukhi. Wait, actually, that's a good introduction. Just start talking and then I'll interrupt you. Yeah.
So, yeah, man. I mean, there's something that
Naveen, shut the fuck up. You're Samukhi Suresh. The timing is off.
You can go again.
Hi, Sumukhi Suresh. She can't hear us.
Why can't she hear us? I mean, how bad is internet that... Internet should first send stuff out before taking stuff in. Yes, really.
I'm also showing off my Yeti microphone. Do you have a Yeti microphone?
I have sunscreen. Oh. Really, she can't. Is okay, wow, she can't. You know, I thought I'd be the one with bad
internet. I just heard sunscreen.
Okay, now, what about everything after that? Can you hear sunscreen onwards or
no much? I just No, I heard him saying, I also have Yeti, and you said, I have sunscreen. And I was like, oh, that's funny. And then I lost you. Am I audible?
Yes.
Oh, no, you guys are stuck. What the fuck?
Naveen is stuck. I'm not stuck. I don't think I'm stuck.
Fake. I'm not stuck. I was just faking it.
Can you?
Now she's stuck. I'm sure that's not a position that you get stuck in normally. That's not a pretend unless, stuck. That's too real.
Unless it's called a Zoom asana or something. Where you just get, dude, that's what they should do in yoga. Where it's like, yeah, imagine you're doing Zoom yoga where you have to hold the pose. And the yoga instructor is just constantly getting confused. Like, are you guys stuck? No, sir. We're just continuing with the pose, sir. You're not understanding. Sumukhi, oh, back again, guys. Sumukhi's gone.
Sumukhi, use your 4G, Sumukhi. I've been saying this for the last 20 minutes. Cut off from the Wi-Fi and use 4G like I am. Get out of your laptop and use your phone 4G. Yaar, kuch bhi yaar ye log yaar.
I tell you, man, these unprofessional Zoom people, you know. Rahil Lakhani, aadha message nahi padho. I said if they talk in Hindi, it will be more funny. Saurabh, you can talk in a language called Arnab. Yeah, your message was you sent two separate messages. Now, I'm not supposed to go through all like if you write two separate paragraphs, but they both speak Hindi. Naveen speaks Hindi, Sumukhi. Of course, they both speak Hindi. What is this? What are these allegations that you've perpetuated against my clients?
Yeah, kuch bhi yaar ye log. Wo to gaya to, abhi kya karenge hum?
Oh, by the way, we have to acknowledge one thing. I've been wanting to do this, but Sumukhi's internet keeps crashing. Is that usually in the show what I ask is my up-top question is, where is Salman Khan, right? That's the question. Now I'm going to change the name of this show today to say, where is Salman Khani Surka? Where is Salman Khani Surka? Naveen Richard, you tell us if you know where is Salman Khani Surka. Please tell us.
Yes. Actually, I think she was supposed to be here, but due to unforeseen circumstances, she may or may not come. We cannot verify this as a fact, but this is a possibility. And just as the rain may or may not come, Khani's may or may not come.
So the truth of the matter, my friend, is I'm going to change the title of this live to Where is Khani's Surka?
Surka. Surka.
26. Oh God, yeah, my children.
Who's baby? Like... I don't know, you're a baby. That sounds like a tiny.
Sounds like a dog, yeah, go ahead.
No, just dog, like a dog. That is some yelping, dude. It sounds like his children are being beaten, but I know they don't get beaten. So then that is a whale. Not a whale. His children aren't whales. A whale. He's pretending to beat them off now.
This is a joke.
Don't hit them.
I have this running joke with my daughter where I give her a karate chop.
Yeah.
And that makes her laugh. And then I realized that she told somebody that I'm going to slap you because I do affectionate slapping to her. So people outside think that, oh, this guy is just like karate chopping and slapping his daughter. I'm like, no, it's a joke. It's like I do karate chop and they go, hee hee, and then she laughs. So I don't know why I'm revealing all these.
What is she crying about? That was a wail, dude. Like she was wailing out there. Like
She's apparently not paid her GST on time. So people are just like, her CA is sitting on her face. So it's just...
That's probably what it is.
Yeah. And also there's a small ladder installed. Okay, on the side of the wall, there's a ladder which these kids climb on.
Yeah.
So it's her turn on the ladder and my son is trying to pull her down. So it's a very complicated political scenario. This is...
I love it. I love other people's children. They're so much fun. The chaos is fun to watch as long as you're not responsible for it. So I like to see chaos in other people's lives from a distance.
Okay, by the way, we have a few super chats coming in. By the way, Nitin Kamani, welcome to level 2 of membership. Just want to announce that on what day are we doing it? On Wednesday, we're going to do a members only live, which is for level 2 and above, which is, I might get a few guests as well. We'll just come and hang out, which will happen most likely at 8 p.m. or 9 p.m. I'll announce the time on communities. So if you're a member, please just keep coming on communities. I'll also announce on our Discord for all our members. And let's read a couple of super chats because people are very excited to have Naveen Richard. Why? Why? I mean, I
don't understand. Get a life. Get out of here. Read a book.
Was Better Life Foundation a pun on Get a Life Foundation?
I'm just going to pretend to be stuck.
The joke.
Whenever I don't like a joke, I pretend to be stuck. I didn't know for the longest time that WhatsApp was actually a play on words of what's up and the word app. I just thought it was a stupid name. WhatsApp, what's the... And 3 years later, it hit me when I was in an elevator. I was like, oh! And I told my friend. He's like, yeah, we've known for many years now.
This is the same thing I had with the B Unic, right?
Yeah!
I was interviewing him and halfway through the interview, I'm like, wait, it's B Unique, right? He's like, yeah, dude, you fucking idiot.
Like, yeah, I knew him for many years before I figured that out. And I was like, ah!
Okay, I'm going to change this. The title of this to Where is Kaneer Surka and Sumukhi? I will change the title. This is changed.
I understand you guys are in Bombay, in the city, and they don't have internet. Sumukhi doesn't have internet. This is weird.
Yeah. Okay, Monish Ahuja has given 40 rupees on Super Chat saying, 77th episode, well done. Thanks a lot, man. We are approaching 100 soon. And
wow.
100th episode is probably going to be a 10-hour episode is the plan, whenever it happens, which will be in about a month and a half.
Wow. I wonder who your guests are going to be. Yeah.
I don't know. It's going to be you and me talking for 10 hours because nobody else... Everybody else will have internet problems or they'll have...
What's your club called, by the way? The club or the membership thing?
Oh,
does it have a name?
It's just called Panties. It's like... Kani's... No, what's your name? Sumukhi Suresh. I forgot who's disappeared and come back.
Wow, she changed the location. Wow, she's really... She just can't hear us.
Sumukhi, can you just do a small favor for me? Just say today is Saturday, the 24th October, just so people know that this is not pre-recorded. And we are not fucking with your heads. Like, this is real. Again, she's frozen. Okay, by the way, let's talk about this. Okay, Kaneer Surka was supposed to be here. Okay? And the... Naveen is again pretending to be frozen. And the allegations were that last night, Kaneer Surka told us that she had double booked on this day. She had other work, which is paying her actual human money. And she had worked for an app called Bumble. Naveen, are you familiar with this app called Bumble?
Yes, I've heard for it. I've worked for that, done stuff for that app as well. But fortunately, I made sure that there was nothing related to Saurabh Pant at the same... Sumukhi and I did a Bumble ad once. And first thing I asked my manager was, do I have anything to do with Saurabh Pant on that day? And they said no. And that's how I make my decisions, is based on whether I booked anything with you.
I see, this is a very good plan. I think every artist in the world should do that. By the way, yesterday I got to tell you an email that I got. Okay, this is okay. And I'll make my shitty joke and then you can again be silenced. Bumble, it's the app which is based on the former England cricketer David Gower, right? Naveen, listen, it's David Gower, the former England.
Sorry, I didn't hear that. I didn't hear that joke. Sorry, missed it, man. Must have been a good one, dude.
So yesterday I got an email from somebody saying personal invitation. Okay. This is the subject I got. Personal invitation to speak at Career Summit live, right? Because this is a new thing to speak at things live. And it says, hello, Kanika Kapoor. That's my personal invitation, saying hello, Kanika Kapoor, and then all this stuff about, hey, we're a great organization and we'd love you to perform at this copy paste stuff. So I replied back saying, goodness. Hey, thank you so much for reaching out to me, Kanika Kapoor. I'm a very famous singer and I'm taking out time to reply to you personally because I'm touched by a personalized message to me. Let me know your budgets and we can go from there. Thanks, Kanika Kapoor. And the title of the email is Saurabh Pant. So, I don't know if this happens to you, but you get an email in the wrong
name. I never got the wrong name, but it's copy-pasted, especially for like, maybe if it's for a TEDx. So I know if it's genuine, if they've taken the time to specify what they like or something like that. They like this episode of that show. And I'm like, all right, this one's a little genuine. And yeah.
Have you ever been on the other side of it where you fucked up while getting in touch with somebody?
I'm sure I've done this several. I mean, I can't even begin to count. Yeah, I'm the king of that kind of stuff, man. So many examples come, just can't grab hold of one. It's a flurry of examples coming to my mind, right? So many examples. apples.
Your internet is also going, by the way. Sumukhi is coming and going. I don't know where Sumukhi.
So many examples. What is the question again?
Is Sumukhi here or no? I'm not understanding. Is she here?
This is wonderful.
This is the bizarrest episode I've done so far. Where we have one guest who cancelled because they double booked. And that's fine, by the way. If you're making money, this episode makes nobody money. So this is just a gesture of kindness on behalf of anybody popping in. Right? And Sumukhi seems to be speaking, but no words are coming.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we can see her video also.
I was planning to go to the ATM today. I put that on hold. That's in a way, you know, with taking money. So I made sacrifices.
You know, this is. And
Sumukhi, I made sacrifices.
Sumukhi Suresh, why is your...
Sumukhi says, I am here.
Yeah, but we can't see you.
I'm here. Yeah, you know what, Sumukhi? Just go put your video off and use your phone microphone to speak into it. But the video is off. That'll save on the internet. And use 4G. Sumukhi, use 4G.
Navi has been saying use 4G for about 1 hour now. And Sumukhi is not... Either she's not trying or it's not working. So anyway, this is the bad internet episode of Wake Up with Saur. I forgot the name of my show. Okay, I'm going to read some super chats. Maya Shinoy. Hi, Maya. I hope you're doing well. Very nice person, Maya. Has given super chat saying, awesome, Naveen, a big fan. When is your next Amazon special coming? Already? She's already like, Naveen, come on.
Give me a chance to breathe here, you know? I mean, and I'm like, you try start writing a special now. There's only one, like, everyone's special is what's going to be Corona themed. What else is happening in everyone's life? That's the big, I'm like, you know, I've got like flight jokes, but they're like, well, taking a flight during Corona, you know, and everything is, that's the only common thread, you know. So I think we'll have to give some time for the Corona to get over and then wait a little bit for normal life to resume for other kinds of relatable jokes to be written. Then everyone does a special.
Yeah, like I think the rush of like now stand-up is starting a lot, and I think the kind of it's going to be a deluge, which is my favorite word, of stand-up clips released in December. Like I think every day for December, there'll be one stand-up clip released of just everybody pending all the content that they've been waiting on. And it's going to be a contest of who releases first. Like that's literally it. Like, you know how they have that desperation for YouTube first comment? It's going to be YouTube first video for stand-up comedians. Whoever, it could be like... It could be a video about ring lights. Oh my God. This is a shock. Let's see who's entering here.
Oh my goodness.
This is a complete oh my God. What is this devastating? Oh, who is this?
She's not at home.
Kanis Circus Clown, how are you doing, man?
Hi, sir. I'm sorry. I'm at my recording studio. I just came to apologize to everybody for missing the live.
Well, at least you have a reason why you have work, right? Sumukhi is on the call, but not on the call. She's been going in and out because she's struggling with internet. So it's even more fun.
What are you guys chatting about?
So far, we've been chatting about how 4G doesn't work. That's basically what we've spoken about for 26 minutes right now.
Amazing.
So what is this shoot? What is this? What is the thing which is paying you money that you dared to?
Please, I'm recording my Bumble podcast. Is Romance Dead? And I'm recording with May, Made in India.
Ah, hey, May.
What's happening, guys? What's happening?
It's live.
Oh, hi.
Why does the demeanor have to change if it's live? Like, drop the energy in case you say something wrong.
No, I might reveal some like really like some weird secrets about my life.
Yeah, it's true.
So can you use love dead?
It's romance. Love is not romance. It's romance dead.
So what is the difference between romance and love? Tell us.
You know what? Listen to the podcast on all podcast apps and find out.
Wow. The plugs have started already. This is it's like, hey, sorry for not being on the show. By the way, watch my other show, guys. Hey, but
she doesn't show up. Then she uses it to plug in her show.
So I'm going to change the title of the show to Worst Internet Episode Ever. worst internet episode ever.
It's not working.
Love
the
itself.
Keep going on and off.
Naveen has also disappeared. This feels like you're having a conversation with somebody who keeps disappearing. But Kanish, let's talk to you. What is this podcast? Does it have guests? Why have I not been called on it and being paid for it? I've been on a show, right? Haven't I been on a show?
Which one?
Haven't I been on the show?
You're married. We don't need you.
You're married. We don't need you. That's what May said. She said this is not a show for. It's about romance. So married people.
One second. There is a lot of romance in married life as well. There's a lot of
Please
romance.
Tell us, what did you do recently that was romantic?
I threw water on my wife's face to wake her up, and then I put a rose on top. I mean, that's kind. That's just kindness. And then I threw a rose, and she's like, "Oh, mera pati Parmeshwar, kitna sweet hai." But
I'm so sorry I didn't invite you.
Yeah, but the thing is that the version of romance changes when you have marriage and kids specifically, because like it's like, so yesterday I watched the kids throughout the day for 24 hours because and it's, and I know that people are like, oh, what a bad father, you should always watch your kids for 24 hours and all this bullshit. We fucking divide duties. That's a normal thing for parents to do.
Yes.
And so
correct.
We get a time to do all of the rest of the stuff is a genius. So I'm just a great person. It's just yeah.
Yeah. I'm not sure what you're talking about, but yes, you are a great person.
Jehan Dumla Wala says, yes, Saurabh was there on one of Kaniz's Bumble episodes.
Huh?
Apparently I was there. Wait, I gotta Google this. Saurabh, yeah,
what are we doing? What Bumble?
Oh, wait, you and Saurabh were on Abhishek's show.
Yeah, that's what we were on.
We were on Abhishek's show.
Yeah.
What Abhishek show?
No, so you guys did Abhishek's The Unexperts, remember? Was it you, Atul?
No.
No. Oh, wait, no, that was you.
Who? What did we do together? Did you Google it? Now I'm so confused. Ask who said that we did something together?
No, dude, is Naveen becoming Mallu Bhau?
Can you guys see me and hear me?
Yes, we can. This is amazing. We've done it, guys.
Oh, shucks.
It's just taken 30 minutes. We've got all the four panelists on.
What is this?
This is amazing. Everybody clap in the chat. This is happening.
No sudden movements. No sudden movements. Nobody move anything. I'm not going to say anything. Also, yes, I think the guy who said that Saurabh was on Karniz's podcast was meaning it as a joke, because Vishal Dadlani.
Oh,
that way.
I've been waiting to say that.
like a tuckloo joke.
Yeah.
By the way, Susan Anthony S210 says Naveen is going to drive to Saurabh's house.
No, I don't have internet around in my house, so I have to go to.
Oh, where are you going?
A viewpoint. I have to go to like a viewpoint area where there's internet.
Just pick up some bread on the way back. Pick up some bread and some jam.
Yeah, okay. Bread and jam. Eggs? Anybody need eggs?
This is like, Naveen is like one of those like students, like who's telling me the story about students in a water tower who get to the top of the water tower, which is the only... Yeah, we are also in the middle of the live, so if you guys cannot talk amongst yourselves. I like how May is not understanding how a recording works. She's like, yeah, no, tell us
about... Excuse me, you're in the middle of my recording.
Hey, your recording is double booked, is what Tanis said. Tanis, I'll tell you, I'll send you a message to her. Tanis said, Saurabh, I would have loved to be on yours, but I have this dumb thing with May, which I really don't want to do, is what she said.
Tanis, thank you so much for coming, Jevan. Yeah. I was not there. Thank you.
Yeah, I was taking Samuki's place.
Thank you.
Sorry, Saurabh. I'm so sorry for disturbing you. Please continue. I'm so sorry.
Hey, no. I'm not being rude. I'm sorry.
No, you're not being rude. We're just trying to make you feel guilty. That's all. Nothing else.
Oh, that's good. Then it's fine. So there's a story of some place where the only place they have internet is on the top of a water tower. So all the students have to go to the top of the water tower to do their online classes. And so my joke was that Naveen is one of those students, right, guys?
That's possible. Naveen could be that student.
Oh, I totally ruined that joke for you.
Gosh.
Oh, I tossed the coin. Anyway, let's talk to Sumukhi. How is life, Sumukhi?
Saurabh, can I go to my recording?
No, Kanish. What if my internet is fuck all again?
I'll just quickly record and I'll come back.
Okay, cool.
No. Please, Kanish, do your duty and please, fast. I will. Yeah. And hi to May and take care of your life. And
Thank you so much.
Bye, May. Bye, Kni.
Bye, Saurabh. Bye, Sumukhi. Bye, Naveen. Thank you.
Bye. Hey, is my internet better now?
Yeah, it's pretty decent. And it's, I think if you can just keep driving for the next 35 minutes, that'll be perfect.
What a
no, I can't get on the highway. I can't get on the highway because my car papers, I have to pay my taxes. So I can't get on the highway.
I have to
drive inside.
Naveen is like Supandi.
Supandi, pona kottandi. Hey!
Why is your camera where it is right now?
It's falling down.
It's falling, dude. Okay, I'm just gonna find a shady spot and park there because it's
wow, macha.
You know what? By the way, I gotta say I appreciate the effort everybody's made to be on the show today. Like Sumukhi with your internet, Naveen driving his car to get to a location. Kanish in the middle of a recording coming in and doing so. I appreciate the efforts, guys.
I'm not joking. I was on a nice 1 hour show yesterday. Everything's going crazy correctly at this point. I've changed 3 locations and I've set up the live and all saying, this is my desk. And now I'm just sitting in my dumb fucking hall and doing this.
Okay, tell me which is a better title. A title that has been suggested by somebody, Nikhil Limaye. Oh, thanks, man. Nikhil Limaye has given a super chat of $5 saying, welcome to comedians in cars getting 4G. Is that a...
or like just... You need to give him money for that joke.
Yeah.
You need to give him super chat.
That was a good one. I'll refund you your super chat. I'll never refund you fucking money.
Never even. Yeah, what the fuck?
Internet is Dead is a great title that Niharika has given.
Internet is Dead, perfect. Done. Because worst today internet literally, episode.
Yeah, worst internet
episode. Ah, like romance is dead.
Yeah.
But internet is dead.
Or fuck up. Freedom is dead. They'll all come.
What do you guys Democracy think of these allegations made by Kanish that romance is dead? Tell me about your personal lives. Is romance dead in your personal lives?
Right now, romance is sleeping for me.
Right. What were you shooting? Okay. You said something which is that you were in the middle of some crazy shoot and stuff.
Who means?
Did you say something like that?
No. Kanish is shooting. Oh, what is that? Are you drinking in the morning?
This is my friend.
Is that how romance is not dead for you, Saurabh Pant?
Oh my god, dude. Yesterday, about 7 o'clock, I was like, I need a glass of wine. And then I had 12. And my wife is like, what a nice father.
Macha Naveen, you're the exact opposite of Hindustani Bhau.
So they'll call and be like, this is here. I'm here to say that just believe in yourself and everybody should be positive and romance is not dead if you believe in yourself.
Are you stuck? Am I stuck? I don't know who's stuck.
Oh, am I stuck?
No, you're fine.
Am I stuck? That's me.
Yeah. You're fine. Naveen is fine. But okay, you know, I think this is a really fun idea. Naveen sitting in the car.
I'm post till then.
Doing motivational speeches. I think that's a really fun idea. Mallu Bhau, who is just a happy person who's telling people that he can do things.
That's a good idea. I should write it down. If I had a pen, I would.
Nav Nair, by the way, on Super Chat has given US $5. Thanks a lot. Saying them boxer shorts, success MC Showreel is the best comedy sketch on Indian YouTube. What happened to the other members of the group, CC Naveen?
Wow, that is a thank you. That's a way back OG fan. What happened to the members of the group? Life. Read the book of Monty Python. You will understand if you read what happened to Monty Python. It's like that. It happens with any group, I think. Eventually, we fall apart.
Why are you looking morosely out of the window while you say this? And then eventually...
What did he...
He spoke about how groups fall apart. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, why? Who fell apart? Macha?
Not fall apart, but you know, like when you start as a comedy,
SNG?
SNG, AIB, them boxer shorts, Monty Python. Even Fry and Laurie. Well, that's a two-man group. So that it happens to everyone.
They never fight apart. They're still cute on Twitter with each other. I like that.
That is there. That is there. But as a group.
Yeah. But also, you know, you miss the fact that Naveen very subtly compared them boxer shorts to Monty Python. That was his first go-to, where he's like, you know what happened to Monty Python? Just like slyly.
Yeah, No, I believe it because I remember when we were going through differences as a group and I was reading Monty Python and I was like, oh, okay. First of all, Saurabh, as if you don't read some Eddie Izzard autobiography and see yourself in it. We all do it.
But then boxer shorts is Monty Python.
I mean, that and all, we've done most live
you
sketches.
You know, fuck my internet. Sorry, Naveen, if I'm interrupting you.
No, you're fine. You're fine. You're fine. She's so mad at herself.
This is the thumbnail for Behti Nag, by the way, right? Like every moment she gets told.
Sumukhi, put off your video and use 4G. And just use the audio, but use 4G. Yeah.
You're fine right now. You're fine. It'll keep coming and going. Don't worry about it. We'll try and keep this as a normal as a conversation as okay. Now let's see. This might
anyway. Yeah, okay, fine.
What is happening?
Macha, you're fine. I'll tell you what, just put off your video and use audio. The internet
Okay, cool.
That's better.
So people tuning in, Sumukhi is there. She's just the voice of God.
So she was saying that her romance was sleeping.
It's true. Huh. It is sleeping. I mean, but nobody's being romantic during this time. Who's being romantic?
Yeah, how romantic can you be on WhatsApp? I mean, if you're really eloquent.
Yeah, see, the thing is, your eloquency will be nice if you meet once or twice so that you have a setup of the person. You're like, oh, this is the guy. And this is how he's talking. So this is how he will be talking if he would have been in front of me.
Yeah, otherwise it could be a full-on facade.
Yeah, it'll be in my head saying, oh, I'm sure this guy speaks like this. And then it turns out to be, I don't know, something else. Then I don't want any more surprises. That's why I don't want to be romantic this year.
It's hard to gauge. It's hard to gauge if someone's playing games or not.
Yeah.
You know?
And I love games, so I'll fall for it.
Yeah, then you do love games. You're a sportsman of love, dude. You love games too much.
Oh, no.
The question is that, have you met any of these prospective people in the lockdown at all? Or is it just Zoom calls and shit? Or is that not even... Or am I completely out of touch and you guys are like, Saurabh, come on, everybody who's dating uses WebEx.
No, like, I do date walks now. This is the pandemic walks, you know. You see, you're 6 feet apart and you go for a walk.
Nice.
WebEx, isn't that a thing where you play like web series?
No, yeah. What is that?
Well, that's MX, sorry. MX player. Okay.
WebEx is that office app. No, Saurabh, nobody does Zoom meetings. Everyone does now like WhatsApp or like a Google Hangout or Bumble Virtual, whatever the fuck. But I don't know. This virtual video date is very fuck all. I tried it once. It's very bad. My internet, as you can see, cannot stand romance clearly.
What was it like in your day, Saurabh? Which is not so long before from my day.
When smallpox was on, what was
happening? Yeah, so that's why
before Yahoo Messenger.
Yeah. It used to be very hard because like you used to be dating somebody and then they die of smallpox. And you're like, are, what the fuck? Yeah, this is like... And one of the biggest problems when I used to be dating was that like so many people were dying of the plague, right? That it was just like, it was a problem. And for a lot of the times, the sexiest people even back then was those guys with the bird masks. We used to call them birdmen, right? And that's the origin of the whole birdman thing.
Yeah.
It used to be great.
That was an insect, sorry. Sorry, came right in front of me. I put up my window, but my AC doesn't work.
That's the weirdest response to a whatever. Insect is going to assassinate you. Like, you're really fearful of dengue.
Guys, I'm calling the internet guy.
No, it could have been a bee, but it didn't sound like one.
Sumukhi is calling. Update, Sumukhi is calling your internet guy. Let's see. She's gone. She's
I would have liked to see how you can tell a lot about a person by the way they treat waiters and how they treat the internet. Waiters test is easy. Most of us pass it. But when you're really frustrated and call your internet service provider, how nice or mean, that really tests your patience.
Okay, so let's do a sample call, okay? I'm the internet guy, you're calling me, okay? And let's see your behavior.
Hey, hi, this is Naveen. She's back. Sumukhi?
Acha, can you hear me?
No.
Fuck.
Hello, Sumukhi?
Hello, am I audible?
Yeah, no, Macha. Yeah, you are.
Don't fuck with me, Naveen. No.
You audible, we can hear you.
I'm a prankster, yaar.
Okay, can I tell you what Naveen fucking does? When he used to be writing for Pushpavali, first of all, right. He has an aversion for yaar, and rightfully so. Everybody uses yaar for no reason. Like, right. Everything starts with yaar, come on, yaar. Yaar, mujhse nahi hota, yaar. Yaar, ye coffee mein chini nahi hai, yaar. First, we were like, yeah, Naveen hates Hindi. And then we were listening, we're like, oh, fuck, it's true. He's right. Yaar is just being used everywhere. And yeah. Then Naveen, whenever there was a dull moment in the writer's room, he'd be like this. He'd be like, yaar, main toh prankster hu, yaar.
It would totally cringe them out.
Hey, let's get technical. I'm actually curious about this. So when you guys, I mean, both of you have worked on a lot of shows like The Office and Everybody Loves Raymond and Game of Thrones and all. But what's the writing process? Like, how do you guys go about doing a Pushpavali or Better Life Foundation? What is
your Better Life separately to him? He has a.
So we start off with the lighting of the lamp ceremony.
Huh. It's common to Pushpavali and BLF.
Yeah.
There's a pigeon release.
Dude, that'd be so fucking funny if you do both at the same time and the pigeons catches fire. And then it's like, this is so inspiring. Where we start with a life sacrifice. So anyway, please.
Oh, wow. We do, we fire people.
Hey, have you fired anybody ever?
Yeah.
How's that been? Did you do the money ball thing of like, hey, your contract is over, and then walk out? Or did you go like...
Yeah. I just said I was almost going to text and fire them, but then I did the whole let's take a walk. So we walked around. I walked around WeWork with that boy. I said, "Go, Baba. It's not working out. You're very useless." So I sent him.
So, but and what is that guy? Is he achieved anything post being fired?
No, the thing is, he's a good writer. It's just he was not the right fit for the room. And I know I did something very. Okay, I can easily be called sexist for this, but it's also fine. Is that my room, I need at least one boy. So Naveen was working on multiple things at that time. He was doing DLF, and then he had, then we did Go Straight, Take Left. So, and he had stuff going on. So it was Radham, Aisha, Sumera, and I'm like, I need one boy in this room, because otherwise it gets two women. Like, So then I'm like, no, let's get one boy. And this boy was just not boy enough for this room, because we started bullying him too much. You can't bully Naveen. Especially in a writer's room, Naveen sometimes will be like, no, I'll say no just to piss you off. Now you prove it. So which is a great energy. Fuck off. Just a great energy for the three of us. But this fucker, we bullied so much. And I'm like, please go, Baba, before we really take it out. He's a good writer, just not the right fit for the show.
Yeah. He had good ideas and stuff. Yeah, just very good.
He would do very well in a good, like a good Hindi show setup, or even in an English show, which is, with a very different tone, he'd be very good. Just he was not right for Pushpavali.
It helps that you should be able to hang out with the person that you're writing with, even if you weren't writing. So,
So, which was... Sorry?
You cleared your throat like it meant a lot there. There was some subtext to that.
No. Basically, what happened is at that moment, I had phlegm. Which is the usual reason why people... Anyway, you asked why, how we write.
Sorry, before you do that, phlegm, say gori. Thank you. Please, Manu. No. Yes, continue, please. Continue. I had to make that reference just to... listen, Naveen is not playing the game. You're supposed to pretend that you can't hear it. Yeah, this is...
Oh, I can't hear you.
That's the joke. Yeah, that's the joke.
I can never hear you. Yeah. Is he stuck now, or am I stuck? Sorry.
Now he's stuck. Now this
okay,
is...
he's stuck.
Yeah.
Finally, he talked to me.
So you write, but I agree with that. I think you need I think that was one of the things that I always missed in the EIC writing room. Was that it was just dudes. It was just dudes writing, and after a point, you're like, I mean, it's great fun with like Sahil and Sapan and me, like just making penis jokes for 1.5 hours. But after a point, you're like, enough.
But also, can I say boys also are very good for a writer's room, because they simplify the process. Women tend to go a little more
in a writer's room in a story, they get very like, you know how it is, you know how it is. So a lot of it is inside your head. Okay. So when we were writing, a lot of our thoughts were also inside our head. And men, the good thing is they tend to simplify everything. You know, that's why men are so, they're so vulnerable for topics like, you didn't understand what I said, the meaning for the sentence. You can easily be passive aggressive with a man won't understand because your thoughts are so simple in their head. So right. When we used to pitch a very unnecessarily complicated idea to Naveen, that was his response where he's like, but I don't get it. I don't understand. It was not that our thought was wrong. It was just too much. So sometimes you got to meet halfway. So which is the best thing about it. That's why I have a boy in every writer's room, but only one. I can't have two. Because when you have two dicks together, they compete. It's a dick fest. One dick is saying, I am funnier than the other. So I'll always have one boy because one boy is always at his best in a writer's room with women. Because he's not competing and he's actually sharing his thoughts. Also, his ego is high to be like, let me tell you what is right. So if you meet halfway, I'm a big fan of more women and less men in a writer's room, but definitely a man because they have simple thoughts. Their thought process is simple and they're good like that way.
I don't know. I'm not sure about that because I remember like, it depends on the kind of writers you're hiring because like what I used to like about the EIC writing room was that there was no... I mean, there was obviously like, yeah, the way the ego you would come was that when the thing became successful, then somebody would like, yeah, mera punchline da, best.
Like, but you guys are friends. Like, if I have like a bunch of strange boys, they do fight. Oh, they compete like hell. Actually, no, even within friends, I've seen this in AIB, I've seen this in EIC and SND and all these places, actually, Dembox Church also, where one joke has to be upped. No, it's like, tack, 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 tack.
Right.
No one is stopping the process and being like, calm down. That's great. You have tags, but what do we do with the story? Which I think, which is good with women where they have the perspective, but men, I think, have a very good idea of simplifying things. Where they simplify the thought and be like, explain it to me simply. Right. I do this whenever I don't have a boy around now. I can't hire someone if they're not around. But I'm like, what would a boy do? Is I'm like, simply explain the situation. Because, you know, men are very like, oh, this is how a motor works. This is how a chair works. It's a simple thought process, which is not too unnecessarily complicated. So that's how I would like about Macha. I was just, are you back?
Yeah, sorry. My phone overheated. So it got cut.
Your background is so nice.
It just got cut suddenly. And it said like temperature is too high. So then I was like, how do I cool this phone down? What's the fastest way? I'm like, do I run around with it, waving it in the air? I'm like, what is the best way to get this? And then I was like, oh, I have an AC. So then I was holding it in front of this freaking fly inside. Then I was holding it in front of the AC and get out! it's gone out.
In case you want to know how I treat my children when they interrupt their life, that's precisely what I do. Like, what? But okay, Naveen, the allegations made here by Sumukhi are that in a writer's room, you need just one man. Naveen, what do you think of these allegations, these sexist prototype in her writing room?
In my writing room. Actually, one Naveen, more than one man. One Naveen is enough. I'm happy.
I mean, what's sexist? I don't know if it's just, I'd rather not say it. But basically, I mean, Pushpoli is the kind of show I've realized, full-on drama show. And nope, I'm not going to say it. Walk myself into a trap.
You have to say it.
No, dude, like, so much drama.
But it's true, he does simplify things a lot. He does make it very like, why does it have to be so intense? Everybody relax.
Yeah, because these women think like, they like, see the games that Sumukhi wants to play in real life, she can't. So she puts it all in the show. And I'm like, yo, this is too crazy.
Yeah.
I don't think people behave like this. And she's like, bro, I know people. You don't know people, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, so then...
This is exactly... Like, oh my God, literally, I said the same thing before we came in. Where I'm like, men simplify things, which is easy for a show. Like, women go too much inside their heads, especially too many women together. You need someone to be like, okay, relax, take a step back, take 5 steps back and give me the simplest thought of that thought, which is always better. Like, now in hindsight, I'm like, oh, that looks better. Otherwise, God, it would just look very vampy and weird.
It so would go, because I watched my, with my grandmother, I watched this Tamil serial every night. And I'm like, how much drama, like, and then I sometimes...
But that too men wrote.
I know men wrote it, but I'm just saying like how much drama, and I don't know if they think about each character so much because I'm like, there's no way people behave like this. But then when I speak to you and Sumera, they're like, oh, people in our family, people behave like this.
Yeah. But you know, it's he's right that it has to be like a little, it has to be edible. Like it can't be so intense The no one wants to like watch it. Everyone's like, fuck, this is too real. No one wants too real also. You need like a little bit.
People be like, there's too much. You know, when we tell, I tell my grandmom, stop watching these serials. It's too negative. So I'm like, for Pushpally also, I'm like, let's put little, little happiness in it.
And I'm glad about that, because that I don't think if a bunch of three girls get together, they would be like, yeah, this is what happens. And boys will be like, relax. Okay, it happens. But it's not fun to watch, which is very good perspective to have. Otherwise, it just gets very...
So when Naveen wasn't around, he said, by the way, Vaishali Thakkar has said it has nothing to do with gender. It's a personality thing, which is probably true. I think it's like, it's not...
this is my experience from my writer's room, Vaishali. When you run your writer's room, you say, babe.
Yeah.
Yeah, it can be that. I mean, there can be overdramatic men and overdramatic women as well.
Yeah. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about, man.
Yeah, call me sexist, but I think women sneeze very cutely, you know.
Yeah.
Call me sexist.
You should just do a whole bit of like, hey, call me sexist. But actually, this is a stand-up bit, which is damn funny.
This is my stand-up bit.
Call me sexist, but you know, call men me sexist, really
but
take
I think
of
women can identify a rat in the house faster than men can.
Call me sexist, but men look great in... Oh, I can't do it much. You continue.
She came up in one.
Yeah. No, this is a Naveen. The moment, you know, it's one of those things where the moment I start doing a Naveen joke, I'm like, it's a Naveen joke. I can't do it. Let him do it.
Yeah.
If he's
there,
means why doesn't let him do it?
Yeah.
Why ruin it?
Hey, but by the way, I mean, to talk about them boxer shot success, MC Showreel, it was literally one of the stupidest, funniest things I've ever seen. I laughed so much. I think I commented on it. Yeah, but stupid and like the complimentary is stupid, right?
Yeah. It was stupid. I remember when
Abhish did it in BLF1, I was so upset.
Right.
Because I was like, yeah, but you know, for people who have watched the success, they were like, no, don't do it.
I mean, it was cool. I mean, I was so glad Abhish did it, because Abhish said that was his favorite video. That's before I ever met Abhish. I think he had some respect for me because he saw that video. And so it was like full circle when he was doing it on BLF.
You're a king of sketches, yaar. Come
yeah,
on.
Yeah, shut up. So jao, yaar.
This is what we do. We have to say, we send long monologues saying yaar to each other. And we are both of us know why.
Yeah, by the way, if you guys are watching this, please like and subscribe and all this stuff that's supposed to be done by human beings. I'll take a few more super chats before people start getting angry. Vernier calipers is what? It's a plant thing, right? What is a vernier caliper?
No, it's a unit of measurement, no? That you can measure the diameter.
Wow, nicely done, man. Well done, Samukhi. Says, I have always missed live shows and so I wanted to be here for Naveen specially. Can I meet you someday? Maybe in Rutard, Puducherry. Love from Arunachal Pradesh. That's so many thoughts, man.
She's coming from Arunachal Pradesh to Pondicherry to meet Naveen. What the fuck, Naveen? What is this animal?
I've come to Arunachal, dude. I've been waiting to come to the mountains again, dude.
Some random girl saying on internet, come to Arunachal, you'll go.
Macha, I need some excuse, dude. Some excuse to go to the mountains. Any excuse?
Naveen once in the US went to the mountains and then got lost.
That was in Australia.
In the
US, I went up a mountain and realized I forgot to bring warm clothing. And I had to use my niece's scarf for my knees to be warm that night. Oh, actually, I got lost in the US, actually.
That's what I thought.
I lost my bearings in the dark. I was stargazing. And then I couldn't find my way back to the tent.
He also got internet at some place where he's like, I don't know why I have internet here.
That was Australia.
I'm always scared.
I got chased by a cow once in Sikkim. I was walking from one place to the other, and this cow got really worked up because I don't know what. Like it looked at me and he's like, "This guy has lactose," and then just got really worked up that I'd stolen milk at some stage in my life. And I got chased by a cow down a chased me up a mountain, and then I ran down the mountain and I realized that cows are pretty they're not that adept in climbing mountains. I realized on the descent that the car is like, I'm done. This is fine.
I would never put myself in these situations. I don't do nature.
Oh, I love it.
It'll be so hilarious. I keep urging Sumukhi to take her there just to laugh, you know, at her complaints.
Yeah. I'll either go silent or I don't know what I'll do. Actually, I don't
know. You're like full physically, you know, even if I make you walk up a mountain just to prove to me that you can do it, you'll hike, yeah. You know, because you can bear pain more than anyone else.
Correct. My so ego and pain threshold will take me forward, but will I enjoy it? I'm not sure.
That and all is for me to laugh. As long as you make it up. And it's worth it. A lot of people, I take hiking, they complain all the way up. But then when we reach on top, they're all right, I'm glad you pushed me in. It's worth it.
I feel like Naveen would just take me up a hill to watch me tumble down.
Wow, that would be hilarious.
But see, one of those zorbs. If you tumble down a hill, it's not as funny as you think it might be. Because I've seen that happen. It's like,
you ran down the hill. You know, once we were walking in Bandra, we were walking to go for dinner, and I keep falling everywhere. Okay, that at least a year and a half ago, I used to keep falling and like hurting my ankle all the time. And we're walking, and I mean saying something. He's walked ahead. I've fallen down, and he's continued talking.
And really, because she falls so quietly, dude. She falls. We're just walking, and usually if I fall, I'll be like, ah! I'll be like, ah! You know. She's so used to falling. As she was falling, she's like, not again. And then she just tumbled. And like, you know, stuntmen roll and all when they jump off a roof. I think she did all that. She's so used to it. I didn't realize.
Then he this is what Naveen did. He's like, and then, Macha! And I was done. I was like, no, it's fine. I'm fine. This is every day. Then I got up and I just walked with like, oh, wait. Both of you are stuck, which is my internet. So I'm going to wait.
Yeah. Hey, by the way, Stephen Jacob, who's a member, asked, is Naveen Richards...
Saurabh, are you back?
Yeah, we've been back only. It's all happening. It's all good.
It's my internet.
Yeah, Stephen Jacob says...
My internet guy has come.
Oh, see, there you go. That'll be amazing. Dude, it'll be amazing if he resolves this problem while we're doing the show. That'll be like, oh, well done. Stephen Jacob asks, is Naveen Richards sitting in a Contessa? Are you sitting in a Contessa? Are you really?
Correct.
Can't hear you.
Oh, you can't hear me? Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, now we can hear you. Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just cooling it down in front of the AC, so I'll have to... Okay, I'll talk till she comes back. Then when she comes back, I'll have to cool my phone in the AC, okay?
But that is a Contessa, right?
Oh, yeah, it is.
Wow, holy shit, dude.
Yeah.
Fuck. Yeah. I haven't seen one of those in like years. How's this Contessa?
Oh, I used to be in Bombay, dude. I can't believe it. If I'd known you're interested, I would have taken you for a drive and all. Let me show you some of its cool features. It's got three different horns.
Internet.
It's got three different... Wait. There's three switches. We have to put off the AC. Okay. This is one horn. Can you hear that?
Yeah.
Okay. Now this is the other horn. Wait. Nope. You hear that?
Yeah.
Okay, now this is the third one. This is the third one. Wait.
That's like a truck horn, dude. Like, dude, I love Sumukhi that the internet guys are in Sumukhi's house as we speak. And they were looking very morosely towards the video like, oh, what do we do now?
They're like, oh my God, is this live? And then they get all shy.
And then somebody's like, "Are Mukesh, saw you on Saurabh's live." And he's like, who's that? Nobody knows. Abhijit Nadu says that car is from Babu Bhaiya ka garage. Yeah. Dude, but that's like, I mean, the fact that a Contessa exists and it's like, seems like working and all is great.
I drove this from Bombay to Kerala, dude, during the lockdown. That was an adventure.
Wow.
That was crazy. Yeah.
Okay, I got to talk more about a Contessa, but first, let's do some more super chats. Monish Ahuja has given 100 bucks. Thank you, Monish. Hi, Richard and Kaniz. I'm always a big fan of your work. Kaniz, are you still on with your Sunday lives? Great job, Saurabh. Thanks for all your great streams. Sunday lives. I don't know. She's gone already. And Monish Ahuja says, hi, Sumukhi. Great to see you on the panel. It was great to see Sumukhi when she was there. Yeah. And Rajat Shah says, it's my long time dream to get an opportunity to do improv with Kaniz and play Antakshari with Sumukhi. Oh, and Nikhil Limaye, we already read. Ajay Satpute has given 400 rupees saying, Sumukhi is awesome with 4 exclamation marks. So there you go, Sumukhi. And Lijo Matthew says, Naveen bhai, do ande aur bread lete a bhai. By the way, great live, guys. So there you go. This is
what live? We're all just like, oh, can you guys hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay, sorry, my internet is trying to be fixed.
That's all good.
So, but you can... Yeah. Wait, I'll keep going and coming back. Is that okay, guys?
It's all good. It's all good.
Wow, Saurabh, thanks. Literally on your live, I'm fixing my internet. That's insane.
We're getting... So many things have happened. We've seen wildlife with flies. We've seen children screaming. We've seen ACs. We've seen different car horns of Contessas. We've seen Kanis in the middle of a record. There's been a lot that's happened on this episode. And your internet's gone again. Anirudh Agnihotri, thanks for US $10 in Super Chat. Who says, in Hindustani, Naveen Richard Bhau is the most underrated creator in India. Star Boys is great. I sometimes revisit it. Thanks for experimenting and making it so amazingly funny. Now we can see
Star Boys.
Yeah.
Yeah. Star Wars is like Naveen baby. Oh, money's also there.
It's done? Your internet is done or what, Sumukhi?
No. I keep coming in and going out. Yeah, so you guys can just... This is like a classic Sumukhi and Naveen and Sumukhi show. Everything is there. You have the lightness. You have guest appearances with Kanis. And then you have one constant character. Then internet is going.
Oh, yeah.
And then
totally. Phones
are getting heated. This is like a classic 8-episode series. That's Naveen
and
Sumukhi.
It's like a bumbling... That's how we pitched BLF. Okay, BLF was a 2-sentence pitch. And we can't believe it got bought. It was at the same time that Saurabh Pant and all that laughter games thing was going on. And our pitch was just a well-meaning bunch of NGO workers try to fix society's problems and something, their bumbling accountant. And I think it got sold on the bumbling accountant part.
Everybody loves a bumbling accountant.
Yeah. So we're all bumbling. It's a bunch of bumbling characters.
BLF is also so much fun. Like the more than the shoot... which is of course fun. The set is a lot of fun because it's just comics and everyone's hanging out together, wants to do jokes, wants to have fun. But there are also moments where like if Aditi, Sindhu and I are sitting in our room, then Kannan will come sit with us because we read a book. Then he'll go back and he'll do jokes. It's a very nice set.
Yeah.
A lot of fun.
So many of the decisions we make as comedians tend to be that, where it's like, hey, this is going to be because I'm going to be in a room full of people I like doing this stuff. Which is
absolutely
quite a privilege.
Yeah. I wonder if people are going to get... I mean, we always wonder, we're like, who's this Ajay Nair was like, man, people are going to get tired of seeing the same faces over and over again and the same thing. I mean, now there is a fresh bunch of comedians to interact with, so that's there. But still, it's the same faces.
Yeah, but it's about doing new things, right? Like, it's about doing new stuff, right? Was there ever this thing to get both... Okay, by the way, we have a... super chat from Akhil Pisharodi who says, did Naveen steal this Contessa from Mohanlal?
No, I think I used to have Mohanlal's Pajero. Not me personally, but he had a Pajero and then when I met him once as a child, I said, do you have Pajero? Did you have Pajero? He said, yeah. He said, and I said, yeah, I think I have it now. He said, all right, cool, I guess. So, no.
Did you?
No, I don't. I don't know if it was a rumor, but it had like a fancy number plate. It's KL1, G1. And like, you know, when you have one as your number plate, you think it's someone.
So it's number important, plate,
number one. So cops used to like respect us and all. So it was like, and that was third hand. So we were like, maybe someone said it might have been Mohanlal's. I don't know. I don't know for sure.
I think you can just go there that it was Mohanlal's.
Yeah, I guess. I don't want to lie. So I don't want to be blatantly like, definitely.
I wouldn't put it past Naveen if he does pick up Mohanlal's Contessa.
Yeah. Would you pay extra if Mohanlal's Contessa was there? Like, would you be like, hey, I'll pay.
No. You just have to make sure there's no rust in the car. You don't care if it's Mohanlal's or not. The important thing is you have to live with the car. So you're going to make sure it's well-maintained, serviced, oil is changed.
Abhi chal ke raha hai, sir. Abhi pata
nahi. Haan, abhi theek hai, sir.
अभी ठीक है शायद अभी चल तो रहा है वीडियो आप देख लो सर हेलो बोल दो इंटरनेट पे आओ
कैसे हो आप सर आपने इनका इंटरनेट 2 मिनट में मतलब ठीक कर दिया 1 घंटे से स्ट्रगल कर रहे हैं
वेट ही इज नॉट एबल टू लिसन ओके 1 मिनट हां आप अब नाउ वी कैन हियर यू
हां आवाज आ रहा है ना हाँ आवाज आ रहा है, आपका भी आवाज आ रहा है। ये इंडिया का नंबर वन यूट्यूब चैनल है, 4 मिलियन लोग देख रहे हैं अभी आपको
यूट्यूब में। चल आपका शक्ल दिख रहा है, हेलो बोल दो, मास्क भी निकाल दीजिए, तो 2 मिनट के लिए पर
हेलो सर कैसे हैं?
अभी अभी आ जाओ, कोई बात नहीं।
हेलो हेलो,
आप बहुत लंबे हो, इस तरफ आ जाओ, लाइट आपके सर के ऊपर आ रहा है।
हेलो सर, बहुत लोग देख रहे हैं आपका शक्ल।
हाँ, बहुत लोग देख रहे हैं। इन लोगों ने मेरा इंटरनेट ठीक किया, अगर मैं इंटरनेट 5-6 बार ठीक नहीं होना था मैं रो दूंगी, ज्यादा कुछ नहीं। क्या हट गया था? हाँ हाँ, अच्छा मुझे समझा नहीं हो क्या होता है, पर आपको समझ गया ना। बस बस, ओ अच्छा ठीक है, ओके ठीक है, थैंक यू सर,
थैंक यू सर, solves the problem, thank you sir, thank you, better Bye. Internet foundation, thank you so much.
You're a joker yaar.
Yeah, man, clown I am, I'm a clown, you know. okay, let's take 2 more super chats. This is coming, Stephen Jacob, thanks a lot for your super chat. Thompson DeCruz says, Naveen, please bring back Uncle Francis, into brackets, prawns. So I got to ask you guys this, was it, so creating these characters, right, whether it's Behti Nag, whether it's Uncle Francis, all the rest, like, so I remember when I used to do characters ages back, the intention was just to fill up time in a stand-up show, because you had 40 minutes of content and you're like, aur kya karoge? And then you're like, let's create some stuff to make it fucking like a flow. Yeah. What is, was there any that, that it's just something you want to do, or is it one of those things where it's like a calculated thing? Where you're like on Instagram, this will fly, which often happens as a thing.
I think there was an Indian version of Snapchat that was trying to be made, and they said, we'll give you money if you give us content. And I took out a pair of old glasses. It was something Snapchat. Remember, I think we were all...
Yeah,
like,
which one was it?
And
Halo.
No. It was some lame thing. I don't know. I'm grateful for them. Because we were like, we all... When we took the deal, we were like, this is a bad deal. You're giving us a little too much money for something that we know no one's going to watch. But we did it. And that's your Uncle Franz. And then they let me upload all of it on Instagram as well. So I was like, this is a win-win situation. I know that's not the kind of romantic story you wanted to hear about Uncle Francis, but that's the truth.
No, you got paid. What's more romantic than money? I mean, people never say that. It's like
that you can take somebody out on a date and get married with that money. That's the romance.
But I think Naveen also agrees that we don't fill up time with characters. Like, I think we both of us enjoy doing different characters. So maybe the birth of the character might have been very like, I guess we'll do it. And then we're like, this is turning out to be something interesting. So,
that's true. The birth of it is always out of necessity.
Yeah.
And then we end up having too much fun with it. Yeah. Like even Xavier, I started doing only because the crowds at the open mic were so bad that I needed to do something to get their attention. And then it started there. So...
Somebody says it was Hike Messenger. Was Hike Messenger?
Hike! Machan was Hike!
Vikrant Yoshi says you're Hike
fucked.
Messenger.
You're fucked, dude. You're fucked.
No. It's not Hike, dude. It wasn't Hike, 100%.
It's not Hike. Vikrant Yoshi, you're wrong. Definitely not Hike. It was
it wasn't. It was something lame like...
Globe.
Chim Cham or something weird. I don't know.
There is a TikTok new version called Taka Tuck or something.
Oh no.
And it's got, and if you think, if you, and by the way, I'm happy. I think it's a great idea, Taka Tuck. If you want to advertise somewhere, please let us know. I'll create a new character called Behti Francis, which is a combination of both. And I'll be happy to take your money. But so the ad, it's called Taka Tuck only, where it's Badshah doing rap. He's like, tick-tock-tock-tick-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-tock-
classic stuff.
Yeah, great stuff.
Make it in India.
Fuck, dude. They don't even try. They're like, just make it, air, but just who cares? We're clapping shit and then we're like, this is new. And do they think we won't notice? Are we stupid?
No, I think they'll just be like, they'll buy. See, the thing is, you know, the danger of cutting off our buying stuff from China is it will open up a floodgate of Indian stuff to be made. And if we only make stuff within our own country, my fear is like, will the quality drop? But then we won't have a choice but to buy, you know. Yeah. So we need, I'm not saying China, we can import from Norway. Anyway, I'm going too far into this.
But at least, you know, I would rather take a Instagram reel over TikTok. I don't know why. My conscience feels better. I'm sure it's the same. and it's the same amount of crap.
But someone's gonna come and say it's classism.
Absolutely. If someone calls me a classist, I am very proud because I don't have no class. So if you're calling me that, I'm very happy. Yeah. But I feel like less icky if I'm doing like an Instagram reel.
I'm fascinated by TikTok. I used to like TikTok also. I'll be happy. Again, I suck up to everybody because everybody will eventually pay us. So that's my, is everybody's great. Times of India, great company. Hindustan Times, amazing. Every company, IPL, awesome. IPL, all cricketers, great. Hardik Pandya at 6 p.m. on Monday. Anyway, wow.
But TikTok, you know, I hated TikTok and then Supriya and Sumera made me watch TikTok. They had this TikTok ID called Team 008 or 7. They are Team 007 and they do TikToks together, okay? And then they started showing me TikTok videos. And first I thought they were just doing it ironic because you know how comics are. They're just And these two bitches are not ironic because they're walking down the road before lockdown and they saw some TikToker and both of them lost their shit. I'm not joking.
Wow.
Literally lost their panties. They're like, oh fuck, it's this guy. And then they just went and told, and they're like, no, we can't tell him to take a selfie, it's too weird. And it was so off to watch them be fangirls, and they get very aggressive. And I'm like, oh, TikTok sucks. They're like, ma'am, shut the fuck up. Who asked you?
Wow.
We call you ma'am?
We call each other ma'am.
Oh, okay. I thought that's the thing. Okay. That makes sense. I thought, like, out of really great respect,
even Kanan thought the same thing. Yeah, where Kanan's like, why are you making people call ma'am? I said, no, I call them ma'am. Then they're like, fuck you, we'll also call you ma'am. Now what will you do?
Nice.
It started with me being patronizing. Now they're patronizing me.
That makes sense. As long as you're... I mean, that's where irony starts. It starts with being patronizing and then eventually it's just ironic. That's where we are at. Swaraj Bhargav says, Pandya aa raha hai. Haan, sahi hai. Monday, 6 p.m. Hardik Pandya and Manan Desai are going to be here. Yeah.
How exciting. I'll watch it.
Yeah, it'll be fun. And he's, you know what, the thing is that it's so weird about public perception versus reality, right? Yeah. Like with Hardik Pandya, the perception is that arrogant, blah, blah, blah. I've been watching so many of his interviews recently to do research for this. Dude, the guy seems like a very sweet dude. Like, I think there is a lot of like swag because he's young and all that stuff. It seems normal and natural. But he seems like a nice dude, man.
He seems a little lonely, it's true. He's quite lalu. I think even his arrogance, you can see that it's quite lallu arrogance. He's very like, they bol diya maine. He's very like that. It's very boy. As you said, he's like one young boy who's trying to be like, whenever he has to. Or else he's very sweet. Nice boy.
What a cricketer, man. I'm like, so, I mean.
Also, it's not their job to be like, oh, great person, public personality. They play well and that's enough. No. Like,
are you watching the IPL?
Little bit. I'm following it on this because my family group goes crazy about cricket, right? So if I don't be on top, and then my brothers are very like, shame me. They're like, how can you not know what I feel? Because I was following tennis. They're like, you'll follow tennis, you won't follow cricket. So I was like, oh shit. So I'll make sure that I read up about everything or watch one or two matches. So I'm like, yeah, crazy, Mumbai Indians, crazy. This is what happens if you have two brothers who are very intensely sports. So now you have to win.
Yeah, yesterday Mumbai Indians on fire, man. That was great.
Yeah, I had to go through that. I'm like, Mumbai Indians killing it. And then my brother video called me. He's like, I can see that you're not watching the match. I was like, fuck.
I like, honey, he needs video proof of the fact that, like, he's like, pakdi gayi tu. Nahi dekh rahi hai kuch bhi.
Because even his kids, both of them are very intense cricket fan. And you know, it's not even about me not having interest. As a rule, I was like, cricket sucks because my brothers like it. So then I never developed interest. So now they're very like, no, you can't be that girl who doesn't know cricket. So they have their own agenda going on. Where they're like, you should be the girl who knows cricket. Yeah. Like, why am I going through this? Just let me go.
No, but yesterday was great because I'm waiting for batsmen to start complaining about like, oh, why are bowlers succeeding? And I'm like, yeah, they also play cricket.
So and I'm bowlers never happy. Succeed, Papa. It's always a fucking batting paradise. And now bowlers, do you want to watch it as a fuck?
I'm fucking enjoyed, man. Naveen, you're not watching IPL at all.
No, the turf was a bit pitchy, dude. That's my issue yesterday.
Yeah. What are your other thoughts on yesterday's match? What do you think, like, what do you think of the bowling?
The middle of the game, I felt like it died down. It could have picked up a bit.
Right.
But they ended on a high.
Right.
So that was good. The commentary, of course, top class as usual.
Right.
But overall, pretty solid match, dude. Pretty solid match, especially Samay Raina.
Hmm.
You know, in the sixth innings.
Since the turf was pitchy, this is a good
match.
After the sixth inning, I was like, this is picking up.
Richard, did you just say Soumya Rayna?
Soumya Rayna was there involved. I mean, he was doing a YouTube live at the same time, so it was great. Who's your favorite performer in yesterday's match, Naveen?
So, without a doubt, it'll be Robin Uthappa. Dude. I mean, he wasn't playing yesterday, but generally, whichever match is going on, I'm like, I hope you're preparing Robin. Even if you're eating, you do it well. So, I thought Robin did a pretty good job while he was at dinner last night, where he was eating dinner, the match was.
And is there any observation with regards to like teams chasing or teams batting first? Any such thing?
Yeah. So, you know, it all starts with the toss, as you all know.
Yeah.
And when the toss goes on, I was like, yaar. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And before you know it, they were like, oh, we'll go first. And I was like, yaar. Sure. Anyway, it all worked out in the end. So I was like, yaar, bus ho gaya.
By the way, you inadvertently actually stumbled upon what actually happened in the toss yesterday, which is precisely this.
Yeah.
Naveen's a visionary, yaar.
He's a visionary, yeah. And who do you think, which team is going to make it to the finals?
I'll say Mumbai Indians.
I think FR has a good chance, dude.
Yeah.
Faridabad Raiders.
Yeah.
They're the underdog in this.
Since they are not there, they're definitely not.
They're the underdogs. I'm an underdog.
Oh, God.
This is, dude, I mean, I was thinking of calling Sumukhi for my IPL discussions, but I think we should call Naveen. Naveen is like his insight.
When Naveen doesn't know something, the whole, it's beautiful.
Right.
It's too fun.
Which rarely happens. But yeah.
Naveen, what are your opinions on the economy currently? Like, what do you think we should do?
Okay. Yeah, first of all of this money printing, you know, what's it going to end up at? Inflation? Yes, most probably. You can hold up the economy with the stilts of printing money, which is what every nation is doing anyway. So, can you blame our country for doing it? No. This is the only solution in a time like this. There is really no other solution. But really, the problem started many years ago when they took the dollar off the gold reserve and let it just stand by itself and everyone followed suit. So, when the dollar crashes, so will every other currency. So, I'm waiting to see what goes on.
He will know about this. You should catch him for something else.
You suggest.
I'm also thinking.
Yeah.
Naveen knows about most of the stuff. What do you not know, Naveen? What do you not like? Actually, more than not know, what does he not like? Because if he doesn't like, he doesn't want to know.
The capitals of countries sometimes.
But you don't dislike it. Like, what do you dislike? You're like,
Okay. So do you think Kenny is a nice guy? Let's talk about something you don't like. Oh, no, wait.
Wow.
Why? Yo, hello, we're hiring for Pushpavali Rice Season 3, Mr. Drama King. Chumma adding masala.
Sorry, I don't have boys who do drama. I have enough girls for that.
Hey, have you ever had a breakup with a friend? This is a thought that I had, okay? Because like somebody was telling me, I was trying to get two comedians on together. And then somebody was like, hey, no, these two comedians don't get along. And then two weeks later, they're like, hey, they'll come together. I'm like, but wait, what happened? They were like, yeah, they broke up and not like breakup, like a relationship breakup, like a friend breakup.
With a comedian?
No, just a breakup with a friend. Like, I remember when I used to live in buildings. I don't want to show off too much, but I've lived in buildings all my life. And we used to play cricket together and there was a friend of mine called Pramil. And we had some weird fight about something.
Is he breaking up with us?
No, some jeep is chasing him.
There's a pineapple jeep behind me, dude.
No, he's like, I'm going.
Like, there's a jeep behind me. If you can see it.
I don't see it.
Yeah, Dagya must be so weirded out. Because when he came this way, I was stuck in the middle of the road. He's going back and I'm stuck in the middle of the road. He must lose any respect for me and my family.
Hey, how is your AC working? In this car, your AC works, or?
No, AC doesn't work, but the blower works.
Ah, that's what I thought. This is Jenny. Or Janice.
Okay.
This is Janice, yeah.
What happened? Did you crash?
No,
his phone fell.
Yeah.
everything's happened. So Naveen is being chased by a pineapple jeep. It sounds literally like the plot of some bad 90s comedy.
When you're writing episode 6, okay, and there was a scene where we had to, Naveen's girlfriend in Pushpavali comes back from China and she gets him a shirt which has pigs on it. And she gets him, so Naveen's, Pankaj likes cream buns, okay? So he gets her custard buns. Right. She gets him custard buns from China. Okay, so we would improvise. And usually when we write scenes, Naveen and I improvise. Naveen has always pushed to be like, improvise the scenes so the dialogues are as natural as possible. Which continues to. Like in season 2, we did the same thing because he said that in season 1.
No, what do you mean improvise the dialogue? Okay, you finish the story, then we'll come to it.
So what Naveen's first season when we were writing, Naveen had come into the writer's room and he said that when we're writing dialogues, you're supposed to improvise. Ideally, if you can improvise with someone, improvise the scene and then write it down.
Right.
Which is something we did for Ghost Ray Takeleth, which is the funda he applies on because he's very good with structure and I just go railing off somewhere. So he'll be like, yeah, continue. Then he will write the whole thing. I'll be like, yeah, cool, we've got it. So then we usually improvise scenes, Naveen and I. Okay. So we were improvising. He was being Pankaj and I was being Swati. And we started improvising the scene. We're like, oh, yeah, I got you from China. Guess what? I got you from China. Okay, I gave him the pig shirt and then I gave him, and I also got assorted custard buns. And this is what Naveen did for the first time. He looked at it, he's like, pineapple? Then that just stayed for the longest time because Naveen loves pineapple custard buns. So even now, if you go see the show, he does goes pineapple. So pineapple is a thing in Naveen's life.
So every
time he's...
I took all the he's not talking to us. He's talking to the pineapple guy. So pineapple will never leave Naveen. Like it was, he didn't come up with pineapple. He wrote pineapple.
Vittu, pinne naale Coimbatore poi, pinne.
You went to Coimbatore tomorrow.
Aye.
You went to Coimbatore tomorrow.
And then, yeah, na Bangalore irna.
Are they cops? You think they're cops? He's talking.
No, and this is Naveen doing small talk with people on the road. Class.
Yaane.
By the way, somebody just said. He's like, go fuck you. By the way, somebody just said that this has a very sting operation feel to it.
Does it remind them of episode 2 of BLF?
Oh shit, yeah. So this is a sting operation. Haan, Gaurav Mehen Dale says sting operation wala feel aa raha hai. So yeah, it literally looks like he's going to entrap somebody right now. This is very exciting. Okay, I'll read two more super chats that have come in. Swapnil Rane on super chat says, really loved both Naveen and Sumukhi in Pushpavali season 2. Great writing and awesome acting. Eagerly waiting for season 3. You're working on season 3 script right now, right?
No.
No?
I'm writing new show. No, we've not been given season 3. Why am I sitting and writing season 3 when I've not been given season 3? I think when we get season 3 is when Naveen might finally come back to Bombay. Otherwise, I don't think he'll come.
Wow, look at this orgasm face, man. My God. Now this is really... like, this
that's really... Naveen trying to switch on his car.
This is such a sensual experience with this contest. Huh?
Sorry. It wasn't starting. I had to turn the car in my relative's house and then I was hoping they wouldn't come out. But then the whole family came out and they were like, hey, what happened?
Is it the relative with that house which overlooks that hill? And
that view. So the grandmother and everyone came out. Then I ended up talking to them.
Oh, wow.
Then the car didn't start. So
that means the relative whisperer.
Yeah. But I don't even know. I don't know if these are tea gardens around them or like weed gardens or something.
It's rubber. Yeah.
Abhijit Sinha has given a super chat saying worst episode indeed for internet fans, not generally. Saurabh, you're a savior and all the episodes have been so special until this Wake Up podcast. I didn't know, knew the geniuses of Lieutenant General Zamiruddin Shah and Manu Pillai, Anubhav Pal, Mohak, Jamie Alter, KV and you. Oh, thanks, man. I appreciate that this is a show of discovery. It's a discovery show.
There really is nice so much knowledge. There is so much. I mean, stumbling upon your show, if it was like a house, it's like a mansion with the most interesting, it's like an amusement park of knowledge in a way, you know? It's fun. So every ride is different.
Look at Saurabh not being able to make a compliment.
Oh, thanks, guys. I appreciate it. I was just waiting for the... I was just waiting for the moment to go backwards like that.
So Sameer was, Saurabh was like, okay, now you're going to compliment. Now you'll give me the punchline, which is a mean thing to say. No, you didn't. Okay.
Yeah. You always expect that. Anu Chandramohan says, Naveen Chetta. How do you say C-H-E?
Jatti. It's Jatti.
What is Jatti?
Jatti is underwear. Anyway.
Okay, now where have you stopped, Naveen, is the question. You've stopped in the middle of the road.
No, it's come back to where I started, but wow. I'm pointing the other direction.
Oh, fuck. It's literally like writing a show with Naveen.
Yeah.
Naveen Chetta's sketch on online Zoom class with Kumar Varun and Rahul Subramanian didn't come up as promised to fans eagerly waiting. Really love your Insta stories, talks and humor. What is this all about, online Zoom classes?
What have you been promised?
Online Zoom. No, I think when I did one of these podcast things with Rahul and KV, and we vowed to the audience that we will do a sketch, like one of these Zoom sketches, as I have vowed with Sumuki as well, that we will do online Zoom sketches. We never get around to it.
Quietly, it will happen. Suddenly, we'll do, and then we'll be like, oh, fuck.
Correct. We'll just stumble upon the idea. Actually, I have one. Okay, cool. We'll discuss later.
Has Uncle Francis or Xavier ever decided to interact with Behti Naak? Has that ever occurred as a thought, or it's too absurd?
Strangely, Behti never interacts with Naveen's characters. We don't.
Yeah.
I don't. Because she's also very... She's such a negative Nelly. It's a no-but situation. So Naveen has to take the scene forward, and that's too much on him. Because Behti keeps saying no. Then the whole onus is on him to take the scene forward. So I usually don't get her to interact with other characters. Because then it's just the other character's responsibility.
Yeah, you can't do two characters. I mean, this is an attempt that has been made, when we decided to do a Zoom show. They were like, let all the characters interact. Like, no, we need straight characters. One person does the character.
Yeah.
Dude, the straight characters, such a fucking like one of the shows that I'm constantly obsessed with is Jake and Amir. I rewatch it every year for absolutely no reason. And it's so interesting, the straight man thing, because people think it's if there's somebody who gets it, right, who gets that, okay, this is not about me and I just have to make sure this other person's thing is, and that's a slightly unselfish way to be, and it's also a fun way because you're enjoying it. Right, you can sense when the person is like, so you go behind the scenes of a lot of this, and the straight man is the guy who's telling the person who's being insane that, hey, you can go this direction as well.
Yeah.
And which is, I don't know if that occurs in your lives.
The sketches we end up doing, like go straight, all the sketches are one straight man, one weird. Even if the person is a weird character, we're like, try and be straight. Unless it was the tennis sketch in our Go Straight. Which we did for Amazon, where both of us are like, fuck it. It was a no dialogue. We just made sounds of, we were playing a tennis match and we were just doing sounds at a tennis match when someone is serving. It was just a random sketch, which is fine. Then you're going all out, where you're like, okay, both of them are absurd and there's not going to be any sense to the sketch. But otherwise it makes sense, no? One straight, one absurd, or one straight, one crazy character.
Did it?
Okay, I'm stuck. Come back. Internet people, come back.
No, we can hear you.
Yeah, we can hear you. And your video's a little up and down, but that's fine. But I've seen Go Straight Take Left, which is really fun. My favorite one was that jail one. That was
that's
so
another
fucking...
one. Yeah. That's so one. Dumb. I think neither of us knew which one is the straight. I think I was supposed to be straight, but I was also, that was a good one, huh?
So, did you guys, while you were doing that show, was it that it was just commissioned by Amazon as a live property, so that's why you decided to do it? Or was there ever a thought where you guys are like, let's do this as actual sketches that are short and then release that? Or it's because Amazon commissioned it as a live property?
No, we sold it to them as a live. They weren't looking for a sketch show which is shot anywhere. They were looking for specials, basically. They were looking for stand-up specials. And we convinced them, like, you go sell this show, because we want a show like this to be on Amazon or whatever.
Are we talking about the jail sketch?
The jail sketch, yeah. And also just about why we chose to do it as a live show and put it on Amazon.
Yeah.
And we always knew we wanted to play off the audience and all that stuff. It was quite a task technically to move around sets and shoot, but yeah.
Dude, because I realized that specifically when you mentioned the jail sketch and the tennis match, I can envision it being, if it's short, right? That would be like on location. I don't know if it would if it would up it or would be the same. I don't know.
See, then it just changes. I feel like when you try and take a live sketch and make it into a short sketch, you have to change it up a lot. Like, it can't have the same rules because there's a lot that we, you know, the since it is not the environment or since it's not a set, we also are a little more free. Like, everyone's just assuming that this is a jail. This is a tennis match. So the audience is also with you in your imagination. Yeah. But the moment you create the set, then the audience expects you to make sure that it's the correct set. Your lines are correct. Like, the believability increases. So, I don't know. I feel like these two, in fact, may not do, but it'll have to change up a lot if it is a short sketch, not like a live sketch. But jail sketch, I'll tell you how it came up. It was very funny.
Yeah, it
was at 6 o'clock. It was my old house, Vakola. And we're like, oh, fuck, we need to come up with one sketch. And both of us are like, yeah, we can do this. And then it just went quiet. And they can do this. And then sitting. And then I'm like, you know, I was like, dude, much I'd be very funny if someone goes to visit someone in jail. No, that was not the sketch idea. I was like, you know, I've always thought how it would be to go meet someone at the jail. This is what I said as an off thought, not as a sketch idea. Naveen's like, oh, okay. He's like, what do you mean? And then we started jamming it, and literally in 20 minutes, we improvised the whole sketch out. And in between, I was like, wait, and he started recording. And in 20 minutes, we're like, okay, cool. Okay, this is the universe.
When we first improvised it, I think we really went down for like a half an hour.
Yeah.
Just improvising. And then we stitched it down to 10 minutes just to see the beats.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was a really fun
one. What a fun sketch.
Yeah. That was I really enjoyed that.
We had a great time. Also, that was the sketch where Naveen's like, go. But even though both of us were crazy characters, one was more talkative than the other. The other one was more expression dependent. We were looking for an equivalent for the rant sketch, I think.
Yeah.
Because we had done Comic San ke liye rant sketch where it was a bike driver where Naveen played the guy who hit my car. Oh, what a great sketch. I love that sketch.
I mean, the whole show is, I wish you'd seen it live. I remember the first time we ever did the show when we also don't know if any of the sketches are going to work. That's so exciting. And that ended up being the best show. And the next best show was the one we did right before the taping in Cuckoo Club. Both the shows, I think, in Cuckoo Club. And
I saw the Cuckoo Club one.
I think the second show of taping was nice. The first show, and then second show, we were like, okay, cool.
No, it was good, but it was never as good as some of those live shows.
That's true.
And people always say, hey, that mosquito sketch, it didn't translate. I was like, yeah, that was a tricky one to be able to translate. You know, it's easier when you're in a live show, you can just buy into the fact that she's a mosquito and it's a perfume. But...
And also the upright bed and all that stuff. I remember that being like, I'm like, oh, that's an interesting way to do this. By the way, Derek Isama Imsa is saying, Sumukhi is looking so beautiful. My crush, what a beautiful smile, Sumukhi. Beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Anybody would notice. Oh, my cleavage.
Yeah. As opposed to where?
Vaibhav Barange has said, good to see Murugan Ashwin on this podcast, but why aren't he talking about cricket?
I already finished, The pitch was moist.
There's a question which is coming. I'm sure this is one which you guys have thought about and whatever. And there's obviously a lot of mechanics behind this. Meghna Chaudhary asked on Super Chat, please get Better Life Foundation on Netflix or Prime. It is already on Hotstar.
I think the second season itself was a stretch. By the time we wrote the second season itself, that flow went off. Now when all of we write, that's all done. It's like the latest season of Arrested Development. It just didn't.
Yeah,
you know, it had all the stars, but everyone went their own way, came back. It was a mess.
Okay, let's take two more questions and then let's end this stream, friends. Please like the stream if you're here. Again, a lot of people popping in and out. We're going to go on for 5-6 minutes more. Like and subscribe to channel, friends. Chinmay Sardesai asks, did Contessa have a breakdown and keep you stranded, Naveen?
Yeah, on the way from Bombay to here on the first day, my brake caught fire. Somewhere in Karnataka, and it was during the lockdown, so there was nobody to fix the car, no mechanics, nothing was open. The nearest town was under a red zone, but we finally found a mechanic who owns the Contessa himself, so that was a miracle.
What are the odds of that, dude? Otherwise, you would have been fucked, right?
I really would have. I mean, it all worked out beautifully, and it was like a true life miracle when that happened. Like, imagine all of them were truck mechanics. Nobody wanted to come. Then one truck mechanic said, "I'll hook you up with a guy." And that guy came up and he said, "Oh, aapke paas Contessa? Mere paas bhi Contessa hai." And then I was like, yeah, right. And he showed me pictures of condos. And then he says, like, aapke paas parts chahiye to mujhe main de dunga and stuff. And he hooks me up with a parts guy. And I'm like, I just needed my brakes. Anyway, finally, he didn't fix the brake. He just cut the brake. And he said, there's nothing I can do. So at least it won't get stuck. So then I drove the next 3 days with like only one front brake.
Oh, I thought he cut the brakes and then like, I'm like, that sounds like a villainous thing to do. Yeah.
He told me that he can't fix it. So at least I'll cut it so it doesn't get jammed again.
Oh.
Naveen's also driven his Contessa where he was manually the wiper. What is it, Majid?
She insulted me once because I took a reverse in my car by looking back, and she was like, wow, Macha, you can drive and all. I was like, hey.
It was the first time ever. I was sitting in Chennai, and as I was sitting at the back, Naveen started reversing, and see, okay, men who can drive well are very hot, and Naveen, when driving, is beautiful. Okay, Naveen's nicely driving, and he turns reverse, and I'm like, oh, wow, Macha, you can drive, and he just got so pissed at me. He's like, that's my fucking thing.
I shifted gears.
You know, it was so much like, it was so much like, I know these gears. And it was not even his car. So I got very like, wow, he can drive. And he was very like, fuck off.
Oh, yeah, it was like, a Skoda. She was impressed because I shifted.
I was very impressed. Yeah. I don't know shit about driving. And I was very like, wow. Second gear.
Yeah, I think it's like watching you cook, dude. When you watch Sumukhi cook, she's so like in control. And like anything you say, she'll be like, Macha, I'll whip up something. I was like, no, Macha, I don't want you to inconvenience. She's like, Dal, dude, 2 seconds it'll take. And of course, it takes about 10 minutes. But the confidence with which, Macha, 2 seconds. Dal tadka I'll make, dude. I'm like, oh, tadka and all. Huh? Wow, dude.
And you give Naveen food. For the first time, I gave Naveen food. Naveen has this thing where he takes the food and he smells it first. It's not in a demeaning way. He first only, in fact, to be fair, he was very like, listen, I smell my food. Don't get insulted. Okay. So he takes it and he goes, good shit.
You don't smell your food, Saurabh. You don't, it's one of the senses.
I smell it with my tongue because I'm greedy. I was like, let's get this
just
done.
Put it there and you're like, like just keep it next to it and just smell it with your tongue.
Okay, this is the last question. We'll take Brijesh. Goharia has given $10 in Super Chat. Thanks a lot. Really nice of you. Jehan Dumlawala is not very happy with the stream at all. So thank you so much, man. He's giving us, saying, disliking this now, thanks. I'm like, you don't have to just dislike it.
But he
it.
Gave it's the fine. Money also for
them. No, he didn't. This is a separate guy. He's
yaar, kya yaar. I'm toh try kar raha hai.
And by the way, Brijesh is the guy who's understanding what's happening. He says, best show, never saw guests taking so much efforts and going beyond to be live and entertaining us. Much appreciated. Sumukhi and Naveen, all-time favorite. Thanks a lot, Brijesh. You're a really sweet man, my friend. I appreciate it. We appreciate it.
This guy gets it.
He gets who we are, friends. And I don't delete Jehan's the message. Yeah, it's fine.
Is this the first live where it was Naveen and Sumukhi only?
Yeah, the last one, you disappeared. And then Kenny and Naveen, and we spoke about spirituality for 1 hour, which is great fun.
Yeah.
Why
are
people Naveen only? I don't know why.
Means? I think you need to have three. I don't know. People like to have three. No.
Because it looks like
that random. It looks aligned. No. That like random. Random Varun, I'm saying.
No, that was four. No, Shreemoy was there.
They were duo. And then we should be the duo. No, why they don't call you us as duo?
Oh. Macha, that's because they own the channel, so they're duo like that.
Yeah,
but then the other duo can be us. No,
I'll come in a duo. I'm just gonna be stuck for my own joke.
Guys, this has been fun and exciting. I hope everybody's enjoyed this. We have had speed breakers and stops, but we've continued onwards with determination and focus. And the two men who repaired Sumukhi's internet, and the six relatives who stopped Naveen on the way, and the one May who took away Kaniz from us, and the rest, and all the super chats. Thanks all for tuning in, guys. Really appreciate it. Thanks for all the hearts and all are coming now in chats. How sweet, guys. How sweet. let's see what anything coming up, Naveen and Sumukhi. Please feel free to plug your lives.
I was just thinking.
What a fucker.
I was thinking.
That face. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway. Is anything coming up? Anything you guys are up to in life?
Having to come back, guys.
Come back to Bombay. Oh, I'm going to conduct a sketch writing workshop for I usually was against teaching, but it's for a cause, for an NGO that fights against sexual violence and all of that stuff. Ritasha Rathore's, Ritasha's sister's NGO.
Oh, nice. Some of you.
So that's on the 1st of November. I don't think the links are out yet, but keep in touch and I will try to teach some sketch writing.
Oh, that'll be a great workshop.
Nothing in detail, just the basics. Yeah. And the cause, for a good cause. So even if you don't like sketches, come and give the money.
Yeah, so you're okay with somebody just giving the money and not attending the workshop?
Yeah, I'm completely fine with that.
I mean, yeah.
I'm only doing it for the, yeah.
If someone is doing that, then please put that link out, because I'm sure there'll be some writer or comic or actor who'd like to learn from him. So yeah. If in case you don't want to attend it, like, or buy it and then just tell us about the link.
Yeah.
I would know 5 people who may not be able to pay but would want to watch.
So see, this is a new thing we started.
Yeah.
So Naveen is doing this to donate the money, and so you donate the money to Naveen and donate that to somebody else. So everybody wins. This is like layers of donation and niceness. So this is a good plan. Samukhi, are you up to any good plans like this? Anything that's happening?
No, I'm just writing. I have nothing else. I'm just writing shows, and I'm going home for Diwali. That's the only thing. In case if you want to join me for Diwali, don't, because I have to go with my parents.
Okay,
I'm done, guys. I miss my parents now.
I hope you leave a little while before Diwali. Don't go correctly on Diwali.
I was thinking I'll go on 10th. Is that okay? Or 14th?
Is Diwali?
14th. No. That would be the weekend.
Wait. Bad idea. You don't want to go when the airport is full and the planes are full. Go as early as you can.
So then go now only.
Yeah, go tomorrow, dude.
No, so the thing is, if you go for... So, if I go to Nagpur and come back, I have to come back within 7 days. Otherwise, I'll have to do institutional quarantine.
Macha, nobody checks like that and all, dude.
That's what I found out when
I've gone to Bangalore, Chennai, come back. I've come from home. I've done all of these
things.
Let's not reveal these things, guys.
It's fine.
Let's not reveal these things in a live.
It's not Hike Messenger. Not Hike Messenger.
Then I'll go earlier. Because then
sorry. No, they checked, dude. Please be careful. Corona.
Yeah, they really should.
Sorry.
So Sumiki is going to be flying. So anyone wants to book for her Nagpur ticket, please do. Monday, 6 p.m. tomorrow. There's no live because my wife's birthday. So wife birthday time. Monday is Hardik Pandya and Manan Desai at 6 p.m. Tonight, I have a show at 6 p.m. before the second IPL match, so come see that. Tomorrow also, I have a show. Today is Travel Pants. Tomorrow is Rant of the Pant. 2 separate shows, 2 different content pieces. So you can buy tickets for both. And it'll be super fun. We do a meet and greet after, so the show will be about at least an hour and a half, which will be fun. So that's on saurabmonth.com. That's about it, guys. Thanks a lot to my mods. Thank you, Sharanya. Thanks to Kajol.
Have a show, but Sumaira's show is happening today in the evening. It's called Dungri Danger. You guys can buy tickets for
that. Oh, that'll be hilarious. Yeah.
What time is that?
She's doing it at, I think, 8 o'clock. It's a Zoom show and the tickets on Insider. And Book My Show, both.
Sumaira is super funny. And see, this is, again, we were just talking about being nice and donating things. And Sumaki has donated her plug to Sumaira. This is the kind of love that we need in our lives. Come for all of those things, guys. Thanks a lot for tuning in. Thank you, Maya. Thank you, everybody. Goodbye. Thanks, Sumaki. Thanks, Naveen.